It's the wig for me.
It's the scoliosis for me.
It's the freaking medicated dog downstairs. I seen them pills.
Disclaimer, the dog's drugs are not recreational. They are prescribed.
It's the rat in a chef's hat for me.
It's the unpaid factory workers that you stole from a third world country for me.
If I were a con artist, here's my bit. I find a rich man. He happens to be an author, but I already knew this. We start dating. I slowly lit on personality traits of his main character, which is crazy because according to him, I have never read it. He falls hopelessly in love with me. He can't stop thinking about me. I'm always there. We hang out a lot, except for whenever he's working. But for some reason, even when he's working, he can't get me off his mind. Oh no, my sister has fallen ill. You have a sister? Of course I do. I have to leave New York. We can't be together anymore. I have to go back to Wisconsin and take care of my family. No, please don't go. You're all I want. You're all I have. I don't know, maybe if you paid to bring her here. Anything for me. I go to pick up my sister at the airport. It's just my girlfriend in disguise. I steal his money and his cat and leave a note thanking him and sign it by his main character. Me and my girlfriend live in a cottage in the woods.
It was scripted. We would never kiss. I only kiss Sour Patch and my mommy.
Dude, you're crying. Oh my god, you're crying. Here, do you want some shit? Here, I have shit. Do you want a granola? I don't know how long this has been in my bag. I just like carry shit. Here, are you starving? You're starving. Here, take it. Here, do you, Fenty? Who doesn't love Rihanna? I'll put some of this on you. Here, listen, I'd fucking rainbow dash. Do you want a rainbow dash earring? Yeah, you do. Are you, like, hurt? I have a fucking princess band-aid. Who the fuck is that? I don't know, but here. You got a boo-boo, bitch? Do you like Minecraft? Here. Pickaxe earring, dog earring, brown pants. That'll match. And fucking Hello Kitty. We can match. Again, we can be, like, best friends. Here, do you want a smoke? Galaxy lighter or pink lighter? Here, take the pink one.
Here's a tip for you. Next time you're having a conversation with a racist piece of shit, and they Ben Shapiro you, meaning like they talk really fast about stuff that doesn't matter, so you get confused, and your tiny little liberal snowflake brain can't handle it, like me, I just tell them that really violently, this is how I do it. I'm gonna eat your fucking face! I'm gonna bite your face off! Prison rules, bitch! I won't even feel bad about it! Yummy, yummy, in my tummy. Now leave, be a piece of shit elsewhere. Got me all riled up. We'll gotta go to the arcade and blow some steam.
Guards, okay, tell me why I'm walking. And this man comes up behind me and he's like, "Hey girl, you hella fine." I turn around and he looks at me in the face and he goes, "Oh, you're a man." Child, and not even that. Oh, not the car behind me. Anyways, not even that. He dead ass says, "Well, it is what it is. A hole is a hole." And I literally have never been catcalled like that. And the fact that he was disgusting and nasty really got to me. My brain cells have disappeared. Oh my god! Look at all these geese! Anyways, I understand when women say kill all men, because honestly, I'm down for it.
Hey, queens. If you're feeling self-doubtful right now, I just want to say that you're fucking gorgeous, and I love you, and I hope you have a really good day. Okay? I know that sometimes you look at Instagram, you see all these unrealistic body types, and you think, man, I look like shit compared to them. But no, you don't. You're beautiful, and you're amazing, and I love you. Okay? All right, have a good day.
I was just discussing something with my mother on the phone that I should have not been discussing, because her first thing anytime I have an issue with one of my kids, take her phone! And I try to explain to my mother that's not how I parent. I was literally just telling her that I was having an issue with one of my daughters keeping her drawers organized and she keeps losing stuff. I'm not gonna take my kid's phone because of that. I never take my kid's phones. I grew up with old school parenting, and I'm proof that it does not work. I used to take my kids' phones at night, 9 o'clock during the week, 11 o'clock on the weekend, nothing good happens after dark. That's ridiculous and absurd. I don't take my kids' phones at all. They've learned how to self-regulate. Of course, the first few, you know, nights that I let them have their phone all night, they were up a little bit later, but who paid the price for that? Not me! I used to think when I asked my kids to take the trash out, you do it right now because I'm in control. That's ridiculous. I literally just said, girls, can you take the recycling out? Because we just got back from the beach. I just cleaned. I'm tired. Can you take it out? But guess what? They were in the middle of playing a game when I asked them. They will get it done. They always do. But I'm not gonna and expect them to do it. Teaching your children the importance of self-regulation and responsibility does not come from a parent demanding. It comes from mutual respect and understanding. Did that just rhyme?
My child just came out as transgender and I'm a Christian mother, so I want you to know how it happens in my house. First, we sat down for a talk so that we could fully understand exactly what's going to go on around here. And then we went shopping and got a haircut. Yeah. This is my son, Jaden. Isn't he handsome? I love you. And hey, listen, no matter who you are, if your kid comes out, you love him. It's your job. You're the parent.
You have to start seeing yourself as the villain. You have to gaze out the window in disgust at the people walking by because you know you're so much richer than them. You have to marry for money and scoff at the idea of love. It makes you gag. You're constantly sizing up your enemies, and you always drink out of a goblet. You make bold, dramatic choices. You're the villain everyone loves to hate and hates to love. The villains are all hotter anyway. The only reason anyone watches the show is to watch you burn it to the ground.
I am a gay! I am a gay! I'm a gay!
I'm a freak bitch, handcuffs, leashes, switch my wig, make him feel like a G10, put him on his knees, give him something to believe in, never lost a fight, but I'm looking for a beat. In the food chain, I'm the one that eats you, if he hate my ass, he's a bottom feeder. Big D stand for big demeanor, I can make you bust before I ever meet you.
Ushy gushy, my pussy, he wanna take him a looky. Ushy gushy, my p-p-p-p.
Go. Wildcard, show the first photo in your camera roll and explain.
So this is my mom and I. She really wanted a girl, but she got a gay.
A fucking god. I love it. Love it when I can influence strangers into breaking the fucking law. Oh no, what did you do, Claire? Did you convince the strangers you met at an empty and abandoned CVS parking lot at 3 a.m. to hang up the dead bodies you have in your closet with the meat hooks you recently purchased? No, nothing of the sort. I simply just crossed the street while the stop signal is on, convincing five other people on the other side to join me in being absolute traffic degenerates. The power I hold, absolutely immeasurable, infinite even. I'm all-knowing and all-seeing, bitch. I am a trendsetter, a pioneer, an innovator. Oh my god, it feels good to be absolutely indestructible, completely immortal. I will live forever. No one can touch me. Absolutely no one.
Why would you do that? I'm gonna turn into a moray! I'm gonna turn into a moray!
Friends are fun, correct Mundo, but the most important thing is finding out who's a good egg and who you should leave in the dust.
I think beating up nerds is funny and cool.
As if. Eat my shorts.
We have a lot of common interests, and I respect you.
Cool beans. Wanna hang out? Booyah, friends for life. Talking to your peers can feel like a horror movie. Scary and spooky. It's time to face your fears and stay true to yourself. Just like that, you'll have a good buddy in no time flat. And Bingo was his name-o.
My child, getting strangers to jaywalk is simply not chaotic evil. However, convincing several men that they're absolutely head over heels in love with you, making them purchase a single one-way ticket to some beautiful undisclosed location for a romantic getaway, and upon arrival giving them a single water bottle and telling them to run as you strap on your semi-automatic weapon because you are about to hunt them, might be. And to push this a little further, upon capturing them, because no man has ever been able to escape me, you rip open their bodies and sell their organs on the black market for profit. That is true chaotic evil, or dare I say, even chaotic good. I really don't know. You can be the judge of that. Either way, it's pretty chaotic, and I absolutely love it.
Hi. It's been a really long time since we talked, huh? Yeah, I think the last time that we talked, oh my goodness, it's like 2 years ago, and I was like, she can't be my partner because she's gay. I'm sorry about that. What? You go by they, them pronouns now? Okay, thank you for telling me. I was like, they can't be my partner because they're gay, and like, I would give anything to take back that time in my life. Anything. It's so messed up because I genuinely thought I was helping people. I genuinely thought I was spreading the word of God and being a good Christian and oh my, to be completely honest, I had just discovered that I like girls and I did not want to be kicked out. And I thought if I denied it enough, it would just go away. And it's not an excuse. I never should have taken out my fear on anyone else. And I'm really sorry.
Her guineas, yeah. We at the top floor right there off Duini. Yeah. Oh no, I can't fuck with y'all.
Hi, I noticed that you're still following me, and I just wanted to let you know. I get it. I'm beautiful. But I would never show you even the slightest bit of respect. To be honest, I would rather shove a beehive up my anus.
You see, if you had half the brain cells you claim to have, you would know that Pride Month 2020 was canceled this year due to COVID-19 and was completely dominated by the Black Lives Matter movement. But you know what you didn't hear? One fucking gay person cry about it. One fucking gay person go, but gay lives matter too! Because we know what it's like to be oppressed. So instead, we took to the streets and marched with our black brothers and sisters fighting for someone else's equality. Because we know what it's like. That was our Pride Month this year. And you know what? I'm pretty proud of it.
Real women vote for Trump. We don't need no liberal Trump, yeah. Real women vote for Trump.
So yes, I did. Here's my rating of the top five hottest cats in the Cats 2019 movie. Number five, Monkus Trap. I feel like I shouldn't have to explain this one, but if I do, you just gotta watch the movie, because, like, his eyes, Number four is Mungo Jerry and Rumble Teaser, kind of like as a unit, both of them. I'm bisexual. Number three is the Rum Tum Tugger. It's Jason Derulo. And this one should also be fairly clear and obvious. Again, if you've seen the movie, which you should, it's fantastic. Number two is Taylor Swift Cat. And number one, like, obviously, is Skimbleshanks the Railway Cat, the cat of the railway train. There's a whisper down the line at 11:39 when the night mail's ready to depart, saying, Skimble, where is Skimble? Has he gone to hunt the...
Can everyone do this? Please, everyone, just do this for me. I'll tell you about it, and I'll tell you why, and, like, give me 5 seconds. We just need a salute to a fallen soldier. 5 seconds of silence. It's me. I'm the fallen soldier. I'm catching feelings for a white man.
Biology tells you that you are 70% water. Chemistry tells you that you are 60% oxygen. And physics tell you that you are 99.999% empty space. And I tell you that you're 100%
depressed. I know you're depressed, but trust me, it only gets better. I'm cheering for you.